Rockstar. Rockstar Radio Podcast.
Okay.
Hey, from ghetto to ghetto to rap yard to yard. Hey.
One hook, no, I'm off the guard, niggas. Mad cause I push up. Got your bitch on the dick, whoa, and she doing push-ups. Whoa. Kirkland, I be drinking Fiji water. Fuck around, Bibbles might dive up in your daughter.
That's how
shit,
we started?
I spit hot flame just like I'm the Carter. Young Bibbles ballin'.
Rockstar Radio, that's how we started? Is that how we started?
Off the gate.
Hey, man, just Kapri is up in here, man. Bars on bars, you feel me?
We just fucking around,
that's
too.
That's how we do it, man. Rockstar Radio, we give it up, man. My man just Kapri is up in here.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That's where we insert the round of applause sound
in the building. Just a free, what up?
What's good? I feel great.
You're in Riverside right now. This is the Inland Empire. Where'd you come from?
I'm from Chicago.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Okay, I'm assuming you didn't fly in for this tonight. So
nah.
Where are you coming from tonight?
Oh, I was on Melrose, bro.
Shopping?
Yeah. No, man. I had to go ahead and get everything right, you know, get ready for y'all boys tonight. You know what I'm saying?
I got to ask, what are you wearing? Because your pants are really nice. I really like them.
The whole fit, he put it together.
Yeah.
You go ahead and give us a Grammy red carpet, you know?
Hey, well, you know, shout out Unknown Union. This is a one-of-one jacket. So there's no other jacket like this. And
I was about to be all front. I got
exclusive.
That same jacket.
I got this. They made it in Africa and shipped it over.
Wow.
So the material that's made in here is only in Africa.
Is that where they're based out of, or is this that's where the
They actually got a store inside of the Beverly Center.
Okay.
Yeah, so I did a little runway modeling thing. You know, I wouldn't say that's like my like main job, but you know, I do a little modeling on the side.
You're very good looking. You know what I mean? This guy's got the model face and you got the height. Have you ever done that? Have you ever actually walked the catwalk?
Yeah, I have, bro.
That down?
It's a different experience for sure.
Now, before you did that, did you get lessons? Like, were you taught? Because there's a certain way to do
it
that.
Is.
You know,
right.
You know how to do the one foot in front of the other.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, and then were you given lessons or you just already kind of originally?
Well, you know, I thought I had the original. Package, you know what I'm saying? When I walked up, I'm like, this should be a breeze, you know. And then I got backstage and I started practicing my walk, and you know, I was back there with a bunch of other models and stuff who had been doing this multiple times. I did it for it was with what was the brand I did it with? I know the guy's name, his name is Sir Joe. He asked me to come out and do it, but Posh Sports, a bunch of other people, Katron Rock was all there, a bunch of other celebrities walking the runway.
Right.
But, yeah, when I was back there, they just really just gave me a little pointers, you know what I'm saying, telling me that, like, hey, you know, be a little more this in your walk, do a little bit more of this. And I was just like, all right, cool. And I'm a fast learner, so
yeah.
I think I got
it. Man, when I was growing up, I think I might have told you about this back in the day before I got into radio. I went to this thing, it's like Academy, I guess we'll call it, and it was called John Robert Powers.
Yeah.
And they were like a modeling / acting agency.
Yeah, that's fire.
They had like a little flat fee, and they'll teach you kind of the business.
I went to something similar.
They got me my first agent, huh?
I went to something similar.
Yeah, like a modeling acting academy, little trade school. Yeah, it was like 6 months or something like that. But I learned how to walk a catwalk there.
Yeah.
And it's a lot to it, man. I couldn't tell you, but I remember learning, like, there's a trick to, you know, removing a jacket.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
So throwing it over your shoulder.
Yeah. Doing that little twist and turn around. Yeah, the shoulder joint, you know? That's what I was asking, you know, if you had all that down.
I don't got all that. I ain't going to cap to you to throw the jacket off part.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
That come natural.
You know, I could probably do that like a little, you know, and then
let's finish
let
this
go.
Joint, though. Okay, so we got the jacket. I didn't see the pants.
Oh, the pants. Yeah, these Unknown Union as well.
Stand it up for the camera. I don't know if they can see.
Oh, man.
Keep you on that side because that's the camera that'll catch
you. Feel me?
Okay, here we go. Wow.
There you go. Ow.
Okay, what kind of material is that on a pants? Is that like a...
like a
what
knit.
Is that, velvet?
Yeah, like a knit. It's like a knit-like type feel, you know, and it's actually real.
Let's get you to move a little to your left. Just one step to your left for the camera.
You feel me?
Oh, Kalisha, I'm sorry. Kalisha was in the way.
I'm in the way. My big head in the way. My bad. Okay.
See. There you go.
Little knit action.
Okay, we got a little knit action on the pants.
This is all Unknown Union.
You know my favorite part, and I'm going to tell you why, of his entire outfit? I mean, it's beautiful, the whole Africa thing, but it's his shoes, the Air Force Ones, because he got them right up the corner, around the corner at the warehouse shoe store.
Hey, look, I had to.
Tell him what happened.
Hey, ain't nothing wrong with finding your ones wherever they fall off the tree at. You know what I'm saying? You know, the ones is essential.
Oh, yeah.
You know, to every player's game, you know.
One of our first interviews here on Rockstar Radio, we had Lil Xan.
Yes.
And he kind of did something similar, man. He was on the way in here. He's like, man, I got to look fresh. You know, he didn't do his hair, so he was driving around everywhere looking for a hat.
Yeah.
And where did he get his joint? He bought it at like a
probably like zoomies, zoomies or something, something like
that on the way in here.
And
I love zoomies.
They left the sensor on the
Oh my God.
You know that
God.
Little joint they put on here?
I hate when they
so
do that.
So where it beeps
shit.
If you steal it. So we made him stay the whole interview with that thing on his head. He didn't have to take it off anyway, but it's hilarious. Oh, it's all online.
I love zoomies, realize. Bro. I love all the little knickknack shops. I use those as essentials. A little PacSun, Zoomies, I feel like you need that
in your life. Pick up a belt or something real quick.
Like a little quick little tee, you know what I'm saying? Every now and again, I like my graphic tees. So.
Which one has the really good graphic tees? Not Zoomies, it's the
Zoomies be having them.
Oh, do they now?
Zoomies, they be having a
Tilly's
bolo.
Got some good graphic tees.
Hot Topic got the little, rocker type shirts,
you know what I'm saying? So I always find my way in the mall. I always go pull up in those little bitties. Right. Little spots, you know, find my
it's
little
It's crazy
knickknacks.
How like how in those are right now, too, with fashion, because I DJ at a lot of high schools, a lot of high schools out here in the Inland Empire. And not to say that they don't know these groups, but, you know, you see a lot of these kids, you know, seniors, juniors, sophomore, freshmen, walking around with like a Led Zeppelin.
Yeah, exactly.
You know
ain't never heard
like,
no Led Zeppelin.
Like, y'all even know who that is?
You know, it's funny, though, on some real
Metallica.
Shit, though, I can pull up pictures. I've been rocking graphic tees and rocking like pretty much the style I've always been. I've been dressing like this for a minute.
Word.
You know what
you
I'm
gotta
saying?
You got to get style, man.
I feel like it suits me, and that's what matters to me.
Word.
You know, I don't dress like everybody.
I feel like everyone has gone through their phase of, like, I want to start my own clothing line.
Yeah.
I want to have my own line. Did
Facts.
You go through a phase of wanting to start your own clothing
I do.
Line?
I don't even want to say it on air right now.
Same,
I don't want nobody to take my shit. God damn. That's a good ass question.
You don't have to give us all the details.
No,
just
give him a little,
I'll give you the
sauce.
Name, and then if anybody steal it, we got it right here, and we taking their ass to court. But I want to start my own clothing line. I want to call it Veil.
Okay.
Veil, like a veil.
Yeah.
Okay. Why is that? Where's that coming from?
I want to call it Veil, and I want to do just kind of like a little off the wall type clothing, but stuff that you would love to rock and love to wear.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but at the same time, it has this twist to it where it's the unveiling. You know,
now, are we talking like everyday comfortable wear? Some you could rock to, like some you could rock that to an award show or something.
Exactly,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, what kind of clothing are you talking?
I want to do it all. I want to have different type of clothes for different type of, you know, scenarios and sceneries. As well as female and male clothes.
Gotta have a female joint in there, you know?
Yeah.
You had the Kalishas of the world rocking it, you know?
Exactly. She got swag, so I gotta.
Yeah,
she may be modeling for me first.
My timeline can't be full of Pretty Little Thing all day, you feel me?
Pretty Little Thing.
It's gotta be Veil in there somewhere.
It's gonna be filled with Fashion Nova very soon.
Okay.
Shout out Fashion Nova, maybe.
Chill.
Oh, yeah, that's a Fashion Nova.
That's a Fashion Nova fit, honey. Okay.
What you rocking at? Kalisha always got something nice on. Okay, you got the denim fit. Okay.
Yes, the whole denim, you know, top and bottom set.
You
know, with the sunglasses. You
oh, hang on.
Let's see. Let's put them on real quick.
All right, stand up real quick. The camera got to get the whole fit.
Yes, the camera. I don't know, my head's gonna get cut off. So.
Oh, hurt him!
You know.
Do the whole thing. Okay. Hey, let me tell you something.
Great.
That's what I love about Kalisha, man. Kalisha always got like her. It's not only is a fit different every time. She got
yes.
a different haircut. I don't even know. Give it a little tug real quick. Let me know what
this
is.
Don't tug it. But
it's okay. As often as you switch it
we
up.
We don't want
know.
The weave to come out, all right?
Okay. No. They stitch it in there pretty good, man. You can't even tell. I mean, it looks like your hair. Looks good, though. I like
don't
it.
Don't worry about it.
How long did it take you to do that joint up top?
Shit, actually, I got my hair done. Pretty fast today. My stylist got me in and
That's
out of
right.
the day. 30 minutes, like 35 minutes.
Okay.
Had me in and out.
There you go.
I ain't talking about the burger spot.
And you already know like, what you want when you go in there. Or you show my pictures. This is what I want. Like, how do they know to make your...
I mean, I think if you're dealing with, like, lock techs and stuff like that, like, you just tell them, like, hey, look, they used to, like, 2-strand twists, 3-strand twists, but I would get mine a little different. I get 5-strand twists. That's because I got a big head. You feel me? So I like my face to show, so I got to get the strands a little bit bigger so they're not a bunch of them all,
right,
all obstructing my vision.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
How you like your man's hair to be? You like it when they're short and faded, or you like the long, is it dreads or is it
dreads.
Like,
dreads and locks, same thing, but we like to call them locks. They said dreads is like a...
Yeah, what is it?
It's a bad name. It's a bad name for dreadlocks.
Yeah.
You know, for locks.
Oh, yeah, dreadlocks.
Yeah, they said it because you dread, like you're dreading.
Oh, okay.
Lock, like,
so what do you call it?
You call them locks.
Call them locks.
I call them whatever I want to. I really don't try to pay attention to what all the world try to fucking depict everything out to be. Yeah, it's all me. I used to have a Jimmy Butler back in the day, but you know what I'm saying? You ain't never seen Jimmy Butler when he got the extensions?
No, I don't know that.
Nah. That shit went viral.
I'm ready to Google it though.
Go ahead, look up the Jimmy Butler dreadlock extension.
Oh my God. Honestly, thank God you don't have the extensions anymore. Cause I feel like, leave that to the ladies.
I mean, tell you the truth, I never had them ever. I was just joking.
All the long joints.
I was just fucking around, just trying to throw a little Jimmy Butler jab. And I love
talking about the Miami Heat.
You got me on that.
Yeah.
Miami Heat Jimmy Butler.
I will never put extensions in my hair. I will never paint my nails unless my daughter did them. Mm. You know what I'm saying? It's just certain things as a man, I just feel like it's you know, left for men.
And so. I'm glad you brought that up. I love that about you, that you fact you like let your daughter like paint your nails. Growing up when I was like a little girl, I always wanted to paint my dad's nails and have fun with him and do his makeup. And I just feel like, you know, it's your daughter. She wants to play. Yeah. Like if they don't have any siblings, like whatever.
Yeah, no. I kind of learned the hard way. My daughter 4 years old now, so I started realizing that she is really a girly girl. Mm. Like, you know, I thought she'd have a little bit of a tomboyish little thing about sports. And nah, my daughter's princesses, unicorns, rainbows, to the umph.
Is she your only one?
Yeah, my only one.
And how old you say, how old is she?
She 4.
Okay, so you daughter daddy. What do you call it? Girl dad.
Yeah, nah, for real. And, you know, at that point, you know, when you see your daughter, what she likes to enjoy, you know, dude, you just keep being like, oh, no, I'm not going to do what you love. Like, no, it's about what she like. Yeah. So, yeah, you want to paint my nails? Go ahead, paint my nails. I can't take them off immediately because she'd get on my ass. She'd be like, daddy, why'd you take off your nails? And I'd be like, oh, baby, it's cool. But then, and I leave them on for like 2-3 days, you know, while she paying attention. And then I just start scraping them off real slow.
You know who my favorite girl dad is? It's The Rock. You ever seen The Rock messing with a little girl? His little girl? Oh, dude, it's so cute, man.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They had this thing where like he lets her put like anything she wants like on his face, and he let her cover his whole face and his big old bald head with peanut butter one time.
Oh my God.
And like I think she did like a lipstick or nail polish all over his face one time. He said it was hard to get off. And you do stuff like that with your little girl? I mean,
honestly, bro, it's her world. I'm just living in it, bro. Honestly, that's real.
Creative on, you know?
Yeah, like that's really how I feel. You know, she's 4 years old. She got imagination. You know, whatever you express and go ahead and get it off your chest. You know, she comes, she try to dress different every single day. You know, she used to be a fashionista. Now she's a rock star.
Like her dad. You know? Fashionista, like her dad.
You know, now she's a rock star. She's like, I'm a rock star. Don't call me a fashionista anymore. Oh, I'm a rock star.
Now, let me ask you something. Now that the holidays are coming up, you know, the holidays is here. Like, how is that for you? Do you know what she wants? Has she been vocal about it? Like, daddy, she sees a Barbie commercial or like, how do you?
I'm real fortunate, bro, honestly, to tell you the truth, because she gets spoiled year-round. You know what I'm saying? So, but it's with the small things in life, obviously. Like, you go to a gas station, you get her a little toy, she's in awe. You know what I'm saying? Like, she likes the adventure, you know what I'm saying, of getting new things, little surprises and stuff like that. I don't think she would ever complain about, I can wrap her an orange, and she would love it. You know what I'm saying? I'm being dead-ass serious. I really feel like if I wrap the orange, and I think I'm going to do that as some content.
There's a viral video that went out, like, a couple years ago, where this kid got, his parents was really trying to teach him to be grateful and stuff.
Yeah.
His parents wrapped him a banana.
Yeah. Oh, I saw that.
Remember? And he started hugging the banana.
Yes, he's like, a banana! He was so
No, for real. Yeah. I really feel like that would be my daughter. I swear to God, I kid you not. Like, if I can get her the smallest thing in the world and, like, she lights up over it. You know what I'm saying? We can go in the gas station and be like a little bitty toy, a little, make a little noise or something. Right. And I bring it home for her, just like, I thought you would like this. And she'd be like, oh, thank you, Dad. I love you so much. I'm like, okay.
What's your favorite part about being a father, a girl dad?
Oh, my favorite part is the person that has made me into be. Mm-hmm. Like, I've always felt like I was patient, right? Mm-hmm. I always felt like I had, like, this level of how I dealt with situations. And having her definitely showed me that I could be more patient. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Definitely showed me I can have a little bit more discernment on how I handle situations. Because if I could say, I can walk into my boss and I can be patient with my boss and, oh, yeah, he say something that I don't like, we be quiet, right? We chill out, boom, boom. But when your kid do something, you know what I'm saying, you quick to try to jump down their throat, you try to boom, boom. But then I realized, too, like, I'm around 30-year-old people, 40-year-old people, and they make so many mistakes.
Yeah.
Like, they mess up all the time. I ain't want to curse.
Yeah, nah,
but,
how you good?
You know what I'm saying? They mess up all the time. So I really feel like, as the time went, I let her make whatever mistake she wants to make. You know what I'm saying? And then I correct her from there. You know what I'm saying? I just tell her, hey, baby, like, you do this, you know, you can get your hand chopped off. Maybe a little extreme,
right.
But you know what I'm saying? But it's like to let you know, like, go ahead and experience, and I'm going to be the person that tells you why we're not going to do this. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And that's the patience that I have with her now, you know, rather than trying to just be all stingy and, you know, stern on how I handle her. I let her do her own thing. You know what I'm saying? And then I just had the patience to break it down and explain to her why I pretty much don't want her to do that. You know what I'm saying?
Father her one-on-one, man. It ain't easy.
Yeah, it's not.
You know?
Yeah. What you know it's about kids, Nick? I'm trying to decide.
Hey, look, Nick Nack love the kids, okay? Love the kids. There's none of my own that I know about yet. I raised a few here and there. You know, I get it. You know?
But you're really close to your nephew.
I'm really close to all my, a few nephews. Oh, my, well, the one that you see the all over my social media probably is Lincoln. Yeah. So him and I, he's like... Four.
You're like his barber.
I cut his hair. I've been cutting his hair since he was like born. You know.
Yeah.
Tom's barber, and he's cool, man. He's grounded right now, bro.
Oh.
Yeah. He's what did he do? Oh, he didn't finish his dinner last night. You know, he ate all the wrong parts. So
grounded for not eating dinner.
Well, he was rushing to get to the dessert or something. I don't know. Okay. So he was, but it was just for a day. So last night he was at the crib, right? And I was watching him and his brother, which is my brother, his dad. Mm-hmm. I was watching him while they went to Costco, and he FaceTimed me while I was on the couch with Lincoln, and we were watching Minions on TV. And he's like, "Hey, what are you guys watching?" And I was like, "Oh, watching Minions." And then I put the camera to Lincoln. He goes, "Put the camera on Lincoln." He's like, Why are you watching Minions? You're supposed to be grounded. And I was like, oh, I didn't know. So I got him in trouble and I felt bad because I didn't know he was grounded.
How old is he?
Lincoln's like 5.
Oh. Man, he's not paying attention to being grounded.
He's like, what's
next?
But the thing that made me feel really bad is that Lincoln thought it was his fault. So like at the end, like he was crying and he's like, my brother's like, we're gonna add another day, you know. So we hung up the FaceTime. Lincoln's like, it's all my fault. I forgot. You know, I was like,
that's heartbreaking.
You know, I was like, it's not your fault, man. It happens. Oh my
God. You're like, I'll talk to your dad for you.
I'm in good with your pops, man. You know, we go way back.
I hope so.
We got just Kapri in here, man.
Yes.
I was gonna ask you about your artist name. Was it ever Kapri at one point, or was it like Lil Kapri or something like that? Nah. Why? Where does the just come from? Like, I feel like, you know, just call me Kapri. It's just Kapri, but that's your whole name is just Kapri.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So how did that happen?
I mean, because just for that right there, that reason, you know, obviously having a football background, having backgrounds in modeling, whatever the case, you know, I would say I'm multi-talented, real estate agent, you know, more things.
Right.
I just felt like it was fit, you know, for people to look at me and be like, oh, what's his rap name?
Mm-hmm.
A little Chauncey, you know what I'm saying?
A little
hot sauce, like, you know what I'm saying? Like
a little pistol starter.
Like for real. Like, you feel me? I felt like that's what people automatically was going to go to. And I'm like, no, I'm just Kapri, you know, just this. My music is an extension of me. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And my voice.
But we
want
to make sure the just is part of the name, though.
Yeah, it is. Kapri. It's just Kapri.
That's
Kapri. So when everybody asks my rap name, it's just Kapri.
That's dope, though. It's a weird, like a double meaning. It's just Kapri. Yeah. It's nothing else, just Kapri, but make sure you say the just.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Gotta get that.
It's like when I, when I'm out there and I'm DJing these spots or hosting events, I can't stand when people call me DJ Nick Nack. I'm like, it's just Nick Nack.
It's just
DJ Nick Nack. You gotta kind of forget people. They don't know.
Yeah, DJ Nick Nack.
What's up, DJ Nick Nack? It's such a mouthful.
Add an extra second to your name.
Yeah. Too many syllables, man. It's just Nick Nack. Just call me Nick Nack, man. You know, because you're right. You do so many things. You know, I'm on the radio. I host events. I DJ. Mm-hmm. You know, I do a lot of different things. I'm a business owner as well.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you feel like when they put a title on it, makes you stick to one lane to what, as far as they know, you know, you don't want to. Yeah. You don't want to be capped like that.
Exactly.
You know?
This is just who I am. This is me. Just Kapri.
Just Kapri. Let's get to the music, man.
Yes.
I gave your joint the car test on the way here.
Yeah.
You know, you got to do that, you know? You ever, like, do that? I'm sure you do as an artist.
All the time. That's the first thing I do after I make a song in the studio. I go straight to the vehicle.
Straight to the vehicle.
Turn that bitch on blast.
Have you ever made changes after hearing it in the car? Like, after you thought it was perfect, you take it to the whip.
I mean, most of the time I get my shit back and there's something that gotta get fixed. You know, I hate people who be like, oh, it's one take. You know what I'm saying?
No, never.
Boom, boom. Like, no, like you should be your own worst critic, you know, when you listen to your music. And if you don't like something, if you think, you know, you could have said a word better, if it can be one little bitty word, I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna get it. Okay. You know what I'm saying? I don't care if I'm going in the studio the next day to work on another song, I'm gonna pull up that track first. I'm like, hey, run this back real quick. Let me fix this. Let me fix this one little line in here, then we can move forward.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Just so I can cover my grounds and my conscience. how I feel about my craft. You know, do I really care or am I just putting some bullshit out there?
Mm-hmm. All right, check this out. A joint in Santa Fe, right?
I'm looking.
Yeah.
All right, let's let me just get in my vibes real quick, you know? It's the music video for Santa Fe?
Yes, sir.
Just Kapri, Santa Fe, let's go.
Santa Fe, cruising, I be chilling with my babe.
Let's go.
Shorty trying to kick it, trying to stay just where I stay. Baby, yeah, I'm from Chicago, but today I'm in L.A. Niggas know my actions, know I'm all about that pay. I'm about that chicken chick. I be dripped out in designer water with the fit. Had to cross some shorty, I been saying no crucifix. And she love me cause I'm vintage, I'm not new to this. I'm not new to this.
I ain't new to this, I'm true to this, baby.
Let a nigga try to play me. I can see a goofy nigga with my eyes closed, that's blindfold. Don't get tripped up on a pothole. Pull up 20 niggas, pop outside the Tahoe. Hey, niggas know my body. Please don't get too sloppy. Beat them down like Rocky. Shorty love that I'm stocky. Hit it with finesse. She love to call me Poppy. Keep feeling on my chest.
Santa
Fe cruising, I be chilling with my bae. Shorty trying to kick it, trying to stay just where I stay. Yeah, I'm from Chicago, but today I'm in L.A. Niggas know my actions, know I'm all about that pay. I'm about that chicken chick, ayy. I be dripped out in designer water with the fit. Had to cross a shorty out, this ain't no crucifix. And she love me cause I'm vintage, I'm not new to this. I'm not new to this.
Let's go.
I'm on God mode. Deep, 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 when you walk with me, she like pre. How she scream for me, ayy. Show me my opponent, catch the penalty.
Hey,
niggas know I'm holding.
Let's
she gon' eat when it come to me. She like pre. How she scream for me? She gon' eat. Hey, she gon' eat. Hey. Santa Fe cruising, I be chilling with my babe. Shorty wanna kick it, she wanna say what I say. Yeah, I'm from Chicago, but today I'm in LA. Niggas know my actions, know I'm all about that pay. I'm about that chicken chick. Dripped out in designer water with the fit. Had to cross a shorty out, this ain't no crucifix. And she love me cause I'm vintage, I'm not new to this. I'm not new to this.
Hey.
Go, go, go. Baby, go. Go, 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 go.
Hey, man.
Daddy.
I like that, Daddy. I just had to end it with her voice with the sexy vocals. She was at the beginning. Was that the same one that was at the beginning of the track?
Uh-huh.
Where she say, "Y'all, don't look at me. You're making me nervous."
Yeah.
Something like that.
You're making me nervous.
You're making me nervous. Who is that? Who you had on that?
Shit, that's a real person right there.
What was her involvement? Was she like just in the studio?
I mean, honestly, tell you the truth, I was in the studio. I was just in the mix, everything, and then she said something while I was in the booth, and I'm like, damn, that kind of sounded a little tasteful.
I feel it.
How about you get on the track and say that?
Yeah, okay.
You know what I'm saying? And I'm like, is she like, for real? And I'm like, yeah, get on the track and say that. And she got on the track and she like,
yeah, you'd be surprised.
You're making
how, like,
me nervous.
You'd be surprised how little vocals and moments like that become like legendary. You know, like things that people remember from the record. It's like, you know, like at the beginning of LL Cool J, the Lounger remix. Go ahead, Daddy. It's the remix.
Yeah.
You know, or like the total vocals on Notorious Can't You See? I can't remember. But anyway, it's cool that you got
it. Yeah, I had to captivate on that moment right there. I heard it and I was just like, go ahead. Throw that in there real quick. The song was already done too. Yeah. And then, boom. And a fun fact about that song is I actually made that song in like 45 minutes.
Word.
Okay.
Dead ass.
I like what the music video I was watching. It looked like you filmed it like on 50 different locations. It was in a studio.
Yeah.
You were performing it looked like in a bar or something like that.
Yeah.
It's like a lifestyle type of
It's a lifestyle
vibe.
Video. Yeah. It was a lifestyle video because at that time when I was making the whole project for 7 days and 7 nights, we haven't got a chance to dive into that. But I made all of these songs in 7 days.
Talk about it.
Yeah.
What was that all about?
Yeah,
where'd that idea come from?
Honestly, I was waking up and I was just thinking like, man, like I love the fact that like I'm musically inclined. I was talking to my videographer, Balen, Bayflix about this earlier, is that like, you know, I obviously play professional football, but I do feel like with music, I'm more naturally talented than I am in football.
Right.
You know, I've never trained music before. You know, I'm obviously a professional athlete in football, but I've trained my whole life.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So the fact that I just started rapping 5 years ago, You know what I'm saying? And the first song I ever released, shit, got over 750K streams. Ooh. You know what I'm saying? So
it's kind of like let you know that, yo, something's meant to be here.
Exactly. Yeah. So, like, and I've gotten better, so much better over time by just, like, you know, critiquing myself and, you know, being honest with myself and real with myself. And all my lyrics is the same way. I never rap about nothing that I ain't did or that I can't do or nothing like that. It's always going to come from Kapri, you know what I'm saying? I don't rap about guns, about shooting people, all that shit, because I don't believe in it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So all my music comes directly from the source. And, that was the whole just anthem behind making this whole track was just to, for me to go out and prove to myself that this shit was really, like, it's easy for me. You know what I'm saying? It's really meant for me, you know? So I went out and made 14 songs in 7 days. Yeah.
You record as soon as you get in the studio? You write your lyrics out prior to you just get in the booth?
I'm just freestyle.
What's that process like this?
Okay. I go put the beat on. If the beat's 2 minutes and 30 seconds, I freestyle the full 2 minutes and 30 seconds.
So this joint Santa Fe was freestyle?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
It's on the video. It's okay. On the video. I dropped another video. It's actually on my Instagram that shows the making of the song. Like, when me just in the freestyle, and it's not the words that's on the song, but it lets you know, like, I freestyled the whole thing, and the same texture of the freestyle is the same texture used on Santa Fe. Mm. What I do is I take the freestyle, I use it like a puzzle. Like, I like certain parts, certain words that I say, which sometimes I've went through songs, and 95% of songs I've kept, you know what I'm saying, from the original freestyle. But I will usually go in there, if I don't like certain stuff, take out this piece, take out that word, I don't like that word, and that will become the homework about, all right, what am I going to place here that's underneath that same texture, same tone, but just makes sense, you know? And then, obviously, I have the vision of the song. You know, I hate rappers that hop on a song and talking about loving a girl and then start talking about lean and fucking all this other shit. Like, damn, bro, what happened to the love of your life? Like, did she fall into a lean cup? Or, like, you know what I'm saying?
A lot of times you think they're rapping about loving a girl, but what they're really rapping about is the girl is the lean.
Yeah.
You
know what I mean? Well, it's like, that's like the money bag yo, the money bag yo trick.
Right.
But, you know, I'm talking about just on a real deal tip. Most people have a song talking about, you know, miss you mama, and then talking about spinning a block five times. Like, I like, whoa.
That's what I was asking. Like the direction you go with your music. Like, Santa Fe is kind of like mid-tempo, you know, it's kind of like got a smooth vibe to the music, but then your lyrics are a little bit more hype, you know. Like, what direction you like taking it better? Like, more like, I mean, if you come from football, do you want to make a joint to hype the team up before they go out in the locker room, you know, or do you want something to kind of like hang out with a girl too?
I like that question, because me and my video, I was talking about this today, actually, about just being universal. You know what I'm saying? I have a multitude of backgrounds. I lived by myself since I was 18 years old. I lived in Utah, Colorado, Washington, California, Florida. And we talking about for multiple years in multiple states. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I love Chicago. That's my city. That's where I'm from. You know what I'm saying? That's my foundation. You know, but I have just natural experience and just loving a different multitude of music. Like, I'm not just a drill. I'm not just a drill cat. Like, you can't just catch me listening to drill for coffee in the morning. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? You don't catch me listening to some, you know what I'm saying, Linkin Park, some Maroon 5.
That.
You know what I'm saying? Some fucking Gwen Stefani. Yes. You know what I'm saying?
Diversity.
Like, I just like that type of stuff just because I think it does open up the ear and it lets me know that you don't have it all figured out. You know what I'm saying? Right. Like, it is stuff that you actually like. But I don't know about country music, though.
You ever? Yeah, that's the one I never really gravitated to.
I couldn't do it, except for the
undeniables.
Yeah.
Like the
I'm in my big black truck. I got my big black nuts.
No, but that one that got
What was that one dude?
Hold on.
The only one where I love it was that Chris Stapleton joint, the Strawberry Wine joint. You know what I mean? What's that song he came out
with? I don't know. The only country group artist that I ever paid attention to was Rascal Flatts. I loved Rascal Flatts.
Oh, yeah, they were cool. Because their lead singer was fire.
I really like them.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody better than Linkin Park, though.
Nelly's my country artist.
Country grammar?
Nah, for real.
That's about the same thing.
Nelly is about the closest I get to country.
Right. That's my country artist right there, Nelly.
I love Linkin Park, too. Let me ask you this, for one Linkin Park fan to another. How did you like their collaboration album with the Jay-Z? Project Necessary with Jay-Z?
Oh, bro.
Of course.
Honestly, that collaboration album with Jay-Z glorified everything in my life at that point.
So great.
Just because, like, I was already listening to Linkin Park. Everybody in the hood wasn't.
Yeah.
So, like, my mama the one who got me into it. So we'd be riding around Southside Chicago. You know, people sell shoes on the side of the street. You know, they was called Airwalks. You know, I know people ain't never heard of those.
I never heard about it. Tell us about these Airwalks.
These Airwalks are just like these off-brand ass shoes that you can damn near only find from
Air Maxes, but Airwalks?
Yeah, but they niggas on the street only sold them, though. Okay. Like, say they come through with these Airwalks, and I remember my mama roll the window down when niggas come sell the socks and sell everything, and she being that bitch, I've become so numb. Like, you know what I'm saying? And we fucking in the middle of the hood, so all the hood looking at us like, who the fuck is rolling through this bitch? And we a car full of black people. You know what I'm saying?
Chicago.
Yeah, like, so it's like, damn, but like, I actually did fuck with the music. But then when the Linkin Park shit dropped, it let me know that I wasn't delusional for the music that I liked. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And it's the all-time, one of the greats, you know what I'm saying? Jay-Z recognized the same goatness in these people and did a whole collaboration album.
I feel like that was like one of the hottest rock meets rap collaborations since Run DMC.
I mean, I've never heard anything close to that.
Oh,
since.
Me neither. Like, I don't think it's happened.
And every single song on that whole collaboration was just that's fire.
Isn't that crazy how close in tempo rock joints are to hip hop? You know what I mean?
Well, I mean, rock was originated from who?
The blues. Right?
And blues started from who?
Who
invented blues? Who invented rock?
Black people.
Exactly. The tempo is meant to be there. Right. You know what I'm saying? That soul is meant to be there. You know, obviously they take rock and they take pop and they do make it like a mainstream, Caucasian type thing, but it's not. Rock was, curated by black people and given to you by black people. You know, but because of the time and age frame that all of it was going on, it was easy for them to take it.
Things was taken. That's a whole different direction of conversation.
Yeah, let's not dive into that on iHeartRadio. We want to keep it all love, saying? All hearts on the radio. We don't want to offend nobody, which I never, try to do. But it's just the truth behind a lot of stuff. Yeah, it's just the truth.
Yeah, we know that. So on your playlist outside of your music, obviously, and who you already mentioned, who you listening to? Like, who's on the playlist?
Shit, I ain't going to lie to you. My top five right now... It's Jess Kapri.
That's how it's gotta be,
You know what I'm saying?
For an artist,
I actually took that from Dylon.
I spit hot fire.
No. I do have my Mount Rushmore.
Who get the cheesecake?
I do have my Mount Rushmore of artists right now. My Mount Rushmore artist is Kanye West being number one. I put Lil Wayne at number two. Number three, it's funny because me and him were at odds for some, because I was keeping it a buck. But Gucci Mane.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Really?
Now you got beef with Gucci Mane.
I don't even know if it's beef, though. It's not even beef.
Talk about it.
It's not even beef.
It's a moment for an apology.
I will. I do want to apologize to him for the context.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? But at the same
time. Let it out.
But, just from the real deal aspect of how I feel spiritually and with God and stuff like that, I'm not going to apologize for that side.
Wait, give me the backstory. Am I the only one who doesn't know?
I don't know either, but I said we apologize.
He blocked me on Instagram.
Blocked you on Instagram?
Yeah.
When was this? How long ago?
This is about like a year and a half ago.
You trying to holler at this girl?
No,
weren't you the one
ever.
I was talking about Gucci Mane's wife? I would never.
I would never try to get at nobody's wife or nothing like that.
Why did Gucci Mane block you on it?
Man, he blocked me because...
On Twitter or where?
Honestly, I was going through my little spiritual awakening, you know what I'm saying? And I was doing my own rating on artists that I felt were close to God and some that I felt were far away from God, you know what I'm saying? And I just had words for Gucci just because, I look up to him. You know what I'm saying? In high school, that's all I listened to was Gucci Mane. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Gucci and Wayne was,
right
there.
Yeah, that was it. You know, Atlanta Zoos, all that, Lemonade, all that stuff was all in the play. Every day I woke up, went to bed, it was all Gucci Mane. But I realized, too, I was obviously very impressionable at that time. 14 years old, 15 years old, boom, boom. And I love that shit at that time, and I was... big in the gang banging and all that other little shit. I'm from Chicago, so that was the world we was living in. But I just said to him, I was like, man, for you to be as big of an artist that you are, I don't think you should only be signing people who are in the streets. You know what I'm saying? People who just owe already have a bad name for themselves and want to continue creating a bad name for themselves. I just feel like you only creating a pipeline and an avenue for people to go to jail and get fucked up.
Well, maybe you gave him something to think about, because recently he turned a new leaf and said he's going to start, him himself is going to start rapping about more positive things and, you know, not.
And that's
so
all
much.
I pretty much challenged him on because, like, you know, you look at every other artist in this game, like, they've had some type of positive impact on the industry. Or they've tried to, at least, the ones that want to stay around for a long time. You know, it don't matter if you're Kanye, Jay-Z, they all go back to the communities, give back to the communities. The only time I know about Gucci is giving back to communities when he signed the biggest drug dealer out the neighborhood. You know what I'm saying? Or, no, I'm just being for real. You know what I'm saying? I'm a fact person. You know what I'm saying? And it's not, I don't even think it's because he don't give back in the community, but he don't choose to advertise that. You know what I'm saying?
About it in this light, too. You know, a lot of times there's a lot of people that give back, but they're not posting on social media.
That's
they're not publicizing it. So we don't know what he does behind the scenes.
And that's exactly what I said, though, is that, you know, it's public. It's public and very public about the fact he went to jail, about all the things that went down. You know, everybody, free Gucci. I was one of those people, too, free Gucci. But, you know, when a grown man like that go behind bars, my uncle just did 27 years in prison. My brother just did 6 years in prison. My other brother did 5 years in prison. My other uncle in jail right now. He's been in jail for 9 years. Like, my whole family's in jail.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So when I see people get out of jail and I watch my uncle start a lawnmower company when he get out of jail and start doing positive shit because he didn't like his time there. You know what I'm saying?
He wanted
to be positive when he got out and show other people that you don't want to be there. And it's like, but Gucci Man got out and it was about, you know what I'm saying, let's get right back on the street shit and let's push this narrative back into our societies and back into our little communities. And I ain't fuck with that. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm like, for you being a grown ass man, 30 some years old, just getting out of jail from doing time, all of us know you ain't want to do with a wife and everything else you had going on, making money, you in there not doing half the shit you want to do. At least express that to the people. You know what I'm saying? About your freedom being taken, about this, this and that. Like, nah, I just got out and it was right back on the same shit. And I was just like, I just can't respect that. I watch real OGs come out the complete opposite and really, you know what I'm saying, really be in the streets for real.
You think old Gucci make better music than new? Like the bigger Gucci than fit Gucci in the six pack?
I mean, honestly, I mean,
I want to say that word. You know, he's bigger. He was bigger before.
I mean, I just think it all comes down to traction because, you know, if you look back at the old Gucci, yeah, he was running the game like a 50 Cent. He had like a 50 Cent run. You know what I'm saying? Like, well, he was, like, nobody was listening to nobody else. Really, but Gucci Mane. Yeah, your favorite artist may come out, but underground-wise, all you listen to was Gucci Mane. Like, so I don't know. I just feel like it can be a lot of better things.
Man, I always say this about all music. The era of music now versus back then is different. Like, the hits we have from back then from certain artists is different from the hits that we have in today's
day and age. Gucci's still coming with it, though. Shout out to Gucci, man. He got a new joint that we just added here.
to
KGGI. It's called There I Go, featuring Michael Made It, produced it. Okay. And he's got J. Cole on that joint also.
Yes.
That's fire.
It's a good song, man.
I just want to conclude on saying this about the Gucci Man topic. You know what I'm saying? Like I said before.
What we saying? Just
for real on some real deal shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's all. It's all for motivational purposes. And if you believe in a relationship or want a relationship with God, shit, I just feel like you should handle his children correctly. You know what I'm saying? And
he's a good father.
No, I'm not talking about his actual children. Oh. I'm talking about God's children.
Okay. He's a good dad. His kids are so cute.
No, I mean, like,
get him double blocked. Right. His kids accounts.
No, I'm talking about God's children, bro. We all got God's children.
Yes,
you know what I'm saying?
That
so,
is true.
You know, like, and I just, I take it as being an artist. Like, that you are privileged with an opportunity to be the voice for multiple people. Yeah. A lot of people do live their life surrounded around your lyrics. Mm-hmm. Like, wake up every single day, eat, sleep, breathe Gucci Mane. Like, you know what I'm saying? You hear kids about that Juice WRLD shit. And I read the whole little documentary, listened to the documentary about kids, like, changing their lives and doing stuff because in the name of another person.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And showing them the light that they actually had in their life by listening to certain music and doing certain things. Like, that shit's real.
Yeah. You know I think you, I mean, I understand where you're coming from, but also, you know, speaking about, like, Gucci, like, he came from a certain type of lifestyle. He lived a certain type of lifestyle because that's, you know, you're a product of your environment. So that's kind of, like, what he knew. You know, he did what he did. He went away. He did his time. He came out. So I think a lot of people, the first thing they're thinking is, like, okay, I want to get back on my feet. I want to get back to like life as I know it. But with everything that's happened in his life from when he got out and the artist that he was signing, which you were speaking about, I think he's seen a lot of things happening with his artist. One of his artists passed away, you know, rest in peace to that artist as well. So I think after he started seeing that, he started to realize, you know, my music is like, he knew it prior probably, but he started to realize more that
his
music
power
really, yeah,
it.
The power, like my music really has an impact.
And that's all
what
I was
I
saying
do
to him. That's
really has an impact. So, I mean, I don't know if he blocked you and so I don't know if you saw it, but he came out and did an interview and said like, hey, I want to, you know, take a different direction with, you know, the music.
And that made my heart smile.
Yeah, take a different direction with the music that I'm doing. I want to be more positive. I want to talk about more positive things, you know, with my music to put out that message. Mm-hmm. So, you know, like people grow. People grow.
Absolutely. And I'm all for it. You know what I'm saying? He blocked me, you know, and
Gucci,
shit.
Let's unblock.
Let's make that unblock happen.
That's all I just want.
Hit that unblock button.
Yeah, for real, bro. I love you, big dog. Like, you know what I'm saying? Ain't never no bad blood. You know, I'm always going, you know what I'm saying, test my fellow warriors. You know
that
what I'm
part.
Saying? We got iron sharpening iron.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying? So that's all I'm going to say. You know, I'm not no drama-filled ass nigga, so I just... Not just, but I keep it a buck, though. You know, if you don't always don't like what I say, it is what it is. But for the fact he's coming to that conclusion now, I don't care when it is. You know what I'm saying? As long as you're still alive, breathing, you're seeing another sun, and you're making that change, shit, you good in my book.
That part.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying?
Straight so. Up. Hey, on the Gucci topic, we never finished your top five. Rushmore.
So Gucci's
number three.
Gucci's
right?
Number three.
Okay.
You know what
let's
saying?
Go for the people that are just stepping in the room. Number one. Are you gonna
Kanye
go
West?
That way?
Kanye West. Number one.
Kanye. Wayne.
Gucci. Number four. I'm gonna give. Oh damn! I tweaked. Fuck, I tweaked. My bad shit. But you gotta put, I'm gonna put Michael Jackson up there.
Of course.
Wait a minute, for artist or rapper? We're talking about
artist of all time.
Oh, this was an artist of all time.
Oh, yeah, miss my Mount Rushmore.
This is a big Mount Rushmore. I don't know if.
Five. Right.
Yeah, I don't know if you could do a Rushmore of artists in general. There's just so many greats.
Nah, man, no, not
it's been
me.
Done. It's done all the time, Nick.
I thought we was going rappers.
Okay.
You're talking all-time artists?
All-time artists for me.
Okay.
It's
okay.
All-time
well,
artists.
Of course,
for me.
Michael Jackson's not number one.
I mean, you gotta like narrow it down to five.
Yeah.
You don't think Michael Jackson would be number one?
I mean, like, just because I would feel like rap is my main, my main go-to. Mm-hmm. You know, I gotta keep the person who made me start, like, you know what I'm saying, rapping. That's Kanye.
That's
Kanye.
The one thing about everybody's Mount Rushmore. It's what's personable to
exactly.
them.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Yeah.
All right, MJ, number four.
MJ really number three. I put Gucci at number four.
Okay.
Let's move Gucci slide a little bit. And then for number five, I'm going to go with Wiz Khalifa.
Okay.
I know that's a little different.
Surprising.
No, I appreciate it when artists have like a top five or a top three that's like different from like everybody else. Everyone's typical top three, top five is always like Pac, Biggie, Nas. Like everyone always has the same. So I appreciate that you have a, you know.
This is wild, man. A Rushmore of generic artists. Like, that's just tough, man.
I love that Michael Jackson in there.
I couldn't do it. It would be too many.
I love that.
Yeah.
Michael Jackson is just like.
But why Taylor Gang? Why is Wiz up there?
Honestly, bro, I like Wiz. I like Wiz because
I love Wiz. But for a top five of anybody artist that's ever made music,
it's lifestyle for me. It's lifestyle. It's the way he talks about his life. It's the way he lives his life. You know what I'm saying? Like he's him. You know what I'm saying? Like he's unapologetically him. You know what I'm saying? And I like watching artists do their thing and not be subject to everything that's going on around them. I hate when I see some shit going on around the world and that artist fall into that shit and fall off a cliff or some shit. You know, I would name some names that have fell into that trap. You know what I'm saying? Then you watch the artists who stay in their lane the whole time and like don't, you know, get involved in other people's shit, jump into this beef, jump into this drama. This isn't that
that's
fueling
true.
That whole game. Like
you never
I don't fuck
drama.
I don't fuck with that. Like I never heard Wiz's name.
Yeah.
Ever in any of that type
me
of
neither.
Drama. That,
me
nigga, that nigga smoke weed and stay out the way.
Mm-hmm.
And I like Chief Keef for the same reason. Obviously, he had a little shit, but like for him to be a Chicago nigga and to come out the hood and keep a low profile, I fuck with Chief Keef like 10 times more than what a normal person would just mm-hmm. because how he carry himself.
I'm surprised there wasn't more Chicago artists in your top. You know, like, we got, like, Common
Kanye,
out there.
Kanye, number one.
Kanye, yeah, oh, Kanye. Yeah, well,
Kanye.
Yeah.
Hello.
I was looking for, like, Chance the Rapper.
Get with it.
Yeah, no, Chief Keef ain't made me start rapping. You know what I'm saying? But definitely Chief Keef is a GOAT. You know what I'm saying?
Chicago, too.
Yeah. If there was a top 10, Chief Keef would definitely be in there.
Yeah.
Just because of his influence. Shit, I say a lot of... I mean, I say go a lot, you know what I'm saying? And people say that's an original Chief Keef thing, but that's really a Chicago mm-hmm. thing. It's a Chicago thing to say go, Chicago, you know what I'm saying? We all say go from there.
Mm-hmm.
But
oh,
like,
okay, it makes sense.
Yeah,
makes
so, sense. But he was one of the ones that, like, made our lingo popular.
Mm-hmm.
And like, just in the mainstream, Kanye never cared about making Chicago lingo popular. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, all that thought, buzz down, boom, mm-hmm. boom, all that shit, like, that... Chicago originated, like Chief Keef put it on mainstream and made sure people gave their credit and let people know how Chicago motherfuckers talk, for real.
Yeah, so a lot of the artists that you mentioned, they all have, like, their legacy that they're going to, like, leave behind with their music or, you know, things that they've done for the community or fashion. Mm. What would you say you wanted what you would want your legacy to be?
Honestly, on my legacy... I think I'm doing a great job right now, especially with, you know, just chasing my dreams. You know, I think if people look at what I got going on in my life, you know, I don't really care for people to have a intricate dive. But at the same time, from the surface, you know, from doing football, music, acting, modeling, real estate, you know, I want people to get the full understanding that it's passion, you know what I'm saying? And it's love and it's faith, you know. By just, like, going after shit that I love, you know, and loving God and letting God take the wheel. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Just having that faith and shit. A lot of times out on a whim.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, fuck it. So it just be what it be. And if people fuck with it, they don't. But funny thing about it is that every time I done went out with that power source, shit, it should always get reciprocated. So, you know, I never question it. I just keep going.
So how would you want people to remember you?
It's through passion.
Passion.
You know what I'm saying? Passion.
One word, passion.
Passion. Passion, love, and faith. You can add, fuck, three words, add them all. But if it's one
passion,
thing for
love,
sure.
I like that.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I'm a passionate person. I'm passionate about humans, passionate about my daughter, passionate about my family, passionate
about... What's your
about
sign?
Capricorn.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah.
That makes a lot of sense.
She knows about all the signs, but I don't know about any signs but my own.
The one thing I've learned about Capricorns recently is that y'all ghost people a lot, like women, like in situations. Y'all tend to ghost women. What's up with that?
Ew-wee, I do not. I honestly, tell you the truth. I mean, like, can I keep it a buck on this thing? I'm going to keep it a buck. And it's just me, personally, as a man, like, and shit. Shaniqua, TT, Shanane, whoever the fuck out there who know Kapri and know, you know what I'm saying, rock with me. I don't have one night stands.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I always, if I decide.
Never?
Nah.
You've never had a one night stand?
I mean, I've never hit a girl and ghosted her the next day.
Have you been ghosted?
Huh?
Have you been ghosted?
Fuck no.
Are you sure?
You never been ghosted by a girl?
My shit on point.
I've ghosted somebody.
Yeah.
I've ghosted.
I've seen legs be ghosted. I've never seen an actual person. She called, hit me the next day, said her legs fucked up. But
oh, my God.
I'm fucking around.
You're too good to be ghosted.
Nah, yeah. But no, I'm keeping the bug out this. I think the real reason is... I haven't been ghosted. It's not because I'm just slanging nothing. Like, no, like, it's just shit. I'm, you know, I would say I'm thorough. You know what I'm saying? I'm real. I never, like, you know what I'm saying, overexceed expectations. You know, I keep it a buck. You know, if I'm fucking with you, I'm let you know I fuck with you. I'm going to do those things in that accord that I fuck with you. You do some shit I don't fuck with, now we talking about a whole different story, because I do get turned off easily.
Mm-hmm.
Very easily. Like, you know, and I do have high standards. So, like...
As you should.
You know, if you do some shit that I'm not rocking with, I'ma voice it to you. Hey, boom, boom. If I see this is who you are and you're not willing to change that thing, oh, yeah, we gonna just, you know what I'm saying, respectfully, you know, we gonna put you on that list, on the friend zone. We can always talk. You can always hit me up. What's good? You know, what you doing? But I ain't finna act like you don't exist no more. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I think that's rude as fuck. You know what I'm saying? Because I do.
You know what? It's a quick life lesson for people listening out there. People be rude as fuck.
Oh, yeah.
No, they do.
Absolutely.
No, yeah. I mean, I've had situations where I looked at that phone and be like, I don't want to respond, but right. out of respect, I will.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, just out of just pure respect, like, for a human, like, I respond. Even though I still tell you, like, hey, I don't fuck with you like that. You did X, Y, and Z. You know what I'm saying? You boom, boom. And then she be like, okay, well, this and that. You know, can we still be cool? Yeah, we still be cool, but don't hit me up like we finna be anything else. Like,
I'm not responding, period. Like, I'm going to give you a chance, and then if I have to give you like more than one chance these days, I'm just
that's a little extra.
No, I'm not. I'm not
one chance.
Oh no, one chance. That's it. Because you're not gonna hit me up on your time when you're ready, when you got free time. No, you're not. You're not gonna reach out to me with your problem that you got a problem, and out of the goodness of my heart, I reach back out, and then you don't hit me back for a day and a half, 2 days.
Oh, that's
disrespectful. Sweet. Like, and after that, you're showing me who you are, so I'm not responding.
I ain't gonna cap to you. I didn't had that happen to me before, though. I've not responded in a day. You know what I'm saying? Message back the next day. But I mean, I'm dead ass be busy, though.
Life does happen, but like, I feel like after so many times, it's like, all right, it's a respect thing.
No, yeah. Oh, after so many times, I definitely make it like if I fuck up and do that shit, I'd be like, all right, my bad, shorty. Like, this is not going on. I make sure I hit a couple double texts for you. You know what I'm saying? Let you know. You know what I'm saying? I'm rocking with your kid. But, you know, I'm not, you know, I just hope that people understand, too. If I'm fucking with somebody, you got to understand I'm genuine.
Yeah.
And I'm not going, you know what I'm saying, purposely put you in a position to make you look goofy. You know, like, I'm only going to fuck with you because I fuck with you. If I don't fuck with you, shit, you can ask my videographer. I say, she's trash.
Goodbye.
Like, what I say earlier, she's trash. Like, it just is what it is. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you got to keep it a buck.
Mm-hmm. You know? We got Just Kapri up in here, people.
Just Kapri,
yes,
baby.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Straight out of
Chicago.
Chi-town.
Yes, sir.
He's in the building. Is this your first time to the Riverside area? Or the city of Riverside?
No, man. I've been sliding through here. I performed at Coachella last year. I came driving through Riverside. Like, I've been through Riverside a couple times. I ain't never had no babies or nothing like that.
Yeah, I'm about to say, there's so many people that are like, if you're not from here, if you've never been here, they always got family or something here.
In Riverside?
In this general area, it's called the Inland Empire.
This must be like the OG area. I feel like that. I feel like there's like, I probably got a lot of OGs out here. It's like it's like a little ghetto out here, then it's real nice out here. So it's like got a good little demographic.
Like it's like the shadow of LA. So you see, like, a lot of people that are from LA, they got family that are in IE or vice versa.
Right. Artists and producers that are from out this way, like Hit Boy, New
My boy Jamal Williams is from IE. Mm-hmm. I play with him with the Green Bay Packers. Green Bay Packers. He's with the New Orleans Saints right now.
Did he play for the Falcons before?
Jamal Williams. He's with the Packers. Then he led the league in touchdowns last year with the Detroit Lions. And then now he's with New Orleans Saints.
Okay. Let's talk about the football. Yeah. Like, you free agent right now. Mm. Are you any plans on getting back into the league? Like, what's up?
I don't know if this is like, if I can fully disclose that type of stuff. So I'm going to leave the full details out. But yeah, I just reinstated last year.
Okay.
I didn't get put on the team last year. And I took 2 years off. Then the third unexpectedly. But I took the original two off because I was with the Green Bay Packers at the time. I had got released for some bullshit, you know, previously from going scratch-free in the NFL. And then I feel like when I had a little incident come through, they burned me. So I was like, all right. And I had my daughter July 25th, the same day training camp started that year.
Oh, wow.
So when I had the Kansas City Chiefs, the Tennessee Titans, and I had the New England Patriots all try to sign me, I turned them down. Mm. And I just decided I was going to wake up with my daughter and just, you know what I'm saying, see how dad life was treating me.
That's
you know?
So important.
Like, you know.
That's a hell of a decision, man.
It was. And I think it was God talking to me, too. My daughter was born the same day. If you look it up on your phone, July 25th, that's the day my daughter was born. The same exact day training camp started. Mm. And I just felt like that was God talking to me, like, what is important to you in life? You know what I'm saying? Like, you said you wanted to be a father. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, I made you a father, and, you know, this is maybe too much, but the mother of my child at the time, she had was going through, like, you know, issues and stuff.
Postpartum,
you know, conceiving
and stuff.
A baby.
Oh, conceiving.
Yeah. So.
You miss it, though?
What? Football?
The league? The turf? The
Honestly,
the action.
Bro, what I've learned about myself, bro, is we talked about the passion one, right? Like, bro, I can go in the backyard with 10 people, bro, and have a blast. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Playing football, same way I can go to 24-hour fitness and play basketball.
But the paycheck's not the same.
Yeah, I do.
It's not all about money, Nick.
That's the whole thing about it is that I learned that very quickly my first 2-3 years in NFL that I wasn't in love with the NFL.
Ah.
I wasn't in love with the NFL. I was in love with football, though.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? The business side of it, the politics and all the other stuff that went on.
That's deep.
Like, yeah, I was not in love with that side. Yeah, like, that side actually pushed me far away, and that's what made me spend that time with my daughter and be like, I'd rather spend that time here than spend that in a place where I know I'm subject to all these different things.
Just like music or anything else. It's a sports business.
Yeah.
You know, it's a whole lot of other side business to it other than what we see on the flat screen.
Yeah,
you know?
Man, I feel bad. I do feel bad from a lot of people who always got to defend themselves when it comes to the NFL and to the NBA or any professional sport. Like, man, I was really the shit, dog. Like, they really just didn't give me a chance. And everybody look at you like, nigga, you sucked. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, but just being real with you, that's never the case. Nobody ever that makes it to that level ever sucks.
Mm-hmm.
It's never about sucking. It's usually your contract is bad, so now you're a bubble player, what they would call you, to where you have money where you can be cut at any point in time and they don't have to owe you any money. So now you become this flexible thing. Now, if somebody gets hurt over here, it's a numbers game, they're going to release you. Because not because you're not a great player, it's because you're the only person out of these 3-4 people that they have available that can cut at any time.
Mm.
And you fell underneath that umbrella. You know what I'm saying? So you got sent to the streets and everybody looking at you like, damn, you trash. And I can attest to this firsthand. I got claimed by the Packers going into my 6th year after I was second on the team in touchdowns, second on the team, third on the team in receiving, and second on the team in rushing. So I was top 3 in every last category on offense and got released. Okay. You know what I'm saying? And it was all.
You ever seen that? I'm sorry, go ahead. Finish.
Yeah, it was all just because I didn't have a guaranteed contract.
Mm.
You know, the other running backs that I had in front of me was Darius Geis, second-round draft pick, Samaje Perine, fourth-round draft pick, and I had Adrian Peterson. All those guys, 10, 15 million-plus guaranteed. I was the only running back in the room that didn't have a guaranteed contract. So if they knew they can have 3 running backs on a team and be good, fuck it. Like, we just going to have to see what happened with Kapri. You know what I'm saying? See if we can bring them back. And they did that. They tried to. They even brought me in. They were like, hey, man, we just got to cut you for 2 days, bro. Hopefully nobody picks you up. You know, we just got to make this move so we can get another long snapper on the team. I'm looking at them like, what would make you think that I would be the guy?
Yeah.
That you would, you know what I'm saying, that you think I'm actually going to be available after I'm number 2 on the team and this, number 3, number 2. Like, what makes you think I'd be available? And sure enough, I didn't even last 10 hours on the waiver wire. I got picked up by the Green Bay Packers, and I was packing my shit the next day.
Mm-hmm.
So, like it's really just a business, and sometimes they don't even actually want to release you. It just is what it is.
Politics.
Like, yeah. So, I mean, like I said, I just didn't want to be subject to all that shit again. You know, I work every day. I used to take 2 weeks off in the off season, 5-6% body fat, dedicating my life to this shit. And music and everything else at the same time. I'm like not burning myself out, but I'm using my energy in a way that I'm only doing what I love and I'm putting my passion behind it. So I'm not gonna let another man walk in and just decide because their numbers is fucked up that it's time for me to go.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, what happened to all my hard work? You know what I'm saying? I put in what happened to all the things I did. And I just told myself I wasn't going to be subject. I just didn't at that time want to leave my life in anybody else's hands. I'd rather create everything for myself.
Mm-hmm.
So I invested like $500,000-$600,000 in real estate, and I fucking hung out with my daughter.
That's the way to go, man. You ever see that show Ballers on HBO?
Mm-hmm.
Have you seen it?
Yeah.
With The Rock?
Yeah.
Is that how it is?
I watched like 2-3 episodes.
Ballers is with The Rock on it. It's a show on HBO. It's on HBO Plus now. It's basically he plays like an ex NFL player turned like a sports agent.
Yeah.
And it's about signing guys in and out of the league and you know, that whole
Yeah,
business.
Nah, it was a pretty good, you know what I'm saying, spot on type of comparison. But I'm gonna keep it a buck, like Hard Knocks, the TV show, Ballers, little shit like that. I used to stay away from it because if it was too close to what I was going through, I didn't want double
you feel away.
Double ears. You know what I'm saying? Like double boom, boom, boom. Why would I go get out of a situation with a motherfucking coach that's pissing me the fuck off, and then I go listen to a damn TV show about how his coach is pissing him off? One thing that's going to make me do is get more pissed about my situation. So I stayed away from little shit like that just to keep myself sane, you know what I'm saying, and keep my head on straight, because you never know. You know, you never know what you people be dealing with shit. And I've learned that even by myself. I had like a little smooth month where I just like, I feel like I fell off. You know what I'm saying? I lost my P card for like a full month. You know what I'm saying? Like I was blasting motherfuckers on IG. You know what I'm saying? Just not like random people, but the NFL. You know what I'm saying? Talking shit about the NFL. You know what I'm saying? Talking shit about that. And I'm not saying I regret it, because I feel like I did need to let my truths out. But at the same time, like, shit, like, I could have been way more P about that. You know what I'm saying? And I look at myself and I self-reflect and I tell myself I never have one of those moments again. You know what I'm saying? I'd rather call my motherfucking mom, call my brother, get that shit off my chest. Right. You know what I'm saying? Look at the gram, stare at it as long as I want to. But no, I'm not finna say nothing bad about what these other kids want in their life and try to tarnish that, anything along those lines. Let everybody go out and have the experience for themselves. You know what I'm saying? I keep my experience for people that just want to hear about it, you know, for me personally, you know.
Just Kapri is in here. Yes, I'm glad you made it all the way to Riverside, man.
Me too. Look, I'm happy to be here with y'all.
Before you get out of here, I want to ask you some quick round of questions. That way people get to know you out here. You know what I mean? All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
Questions with Just Kapri out here. What is something that you are obsessed with?
What I am obsessed with?
We're going to get to know you tonight.
What's your obsession?
What is something that you're obsessed with?
Oh, man, you know what? I'm obsessed with evolving. I am. Yes, I'm obsessed with evolving. I'm obsessed with bettering myself every day. I sometimes go into little moments in my day where if I don't feel like I've done enough for the day, I kick it in overdrive and I fucking burn myself out.
Who was your childhood celebrity crush?
Ooh, shit.
Come on, man.
My childhood celebrity crush was
What's her name?
Alicia Keys.
Ooh. Oh, yes.
Alicia Keys.
Right when she first
Keys.
Dropped, too. Oh, she had blue eyeshadow on a cover of Fallen, that album. Ooh.
That was
couldn't nobody tell me shit about Alicia Keys. Alicia I don't Keys. Give a fuck.
Oh,
and I'm still, she old. She was 50 something, right? 45?
Beautiful.
You know what I'm saying?
Gorgeous,
gorgeous too. Good at one, that, I'm looking still. At Swiss. I'm looking at Swiss B. Like, you got to be the smartest nigga in a fucking. Like,
and naturally beautiful.
Yeah, Swiss like.
Got a good one.
He got
man.
He, man, he. I don't know how the fuck. And then I heard the story about how they got together.
I don't know.
And he was talking about, like, how she ghosted the nigga, like, for, like, all this time. And then she finally gave him a chance, and then it was like fireworks. And I'm just like, yeah. I'm like, fuck. Like, I wish I was like 10 years older at that time, because that would have been me. You had to ghost my ass 20,000 times.
Okay, we'll see.
All right, who would you like to be stranded on a desert island with? You could only have one person. You'd be there.
One person?
Mm-hmm.
One person.
That's it.
Kalisha.
Oh, he didn't even say his daughter. Damn,
I know,
crazy.
Dang. Oh. Me and his daughter.
I wouldn't want my daughter stranded out there starving with me and shit.
That's a good point, though.
That's a great point.
Because you know what I'm saying?
He's stranded starving.
No, I just know.
Dang.
You're a problem. No, you're a problem solver. You're a problem solver. I'm a problem solver. So you got to put heads together.
Okay,
you know what I'm saying? Then also, got to be like a female too. I just can't be on there with another hard leg.
Alright, here we go. Next one. Is pimping easy?
Pimping is actually easy, especially in 2023.
Yeah, okay.
It is so bad. Females,
the pimp game
is females, is they coming out the gate now just want to get pimped. First, you just had to bring a shorty out and trick her to get pimped. Now it's like, pimp me. Choose me. They're like a Pokemon just sitting in the middle of the field.
Next up. Is she fine too or is she 5'2"?
I always thought it was 5'2".
Fine too. What is it, Kalisha?
She fine too.
Are you sure?
Yeah. It is fine too. It is fine too. I got older and it was fine too. Yeah.
Or the moment we all realized that T-Pain's chains on his shirt on that album cover art wasn't really chains.
Really?
Oh yeah, that fucked me up too. That fucked me up.
What was the last lie you told?
The last lie I told?
Mm-hmm.
Mm. The Last lie I told.
She's just a friend.
Hey, we all tell that one though. That's a common. That's a common.
I ain't never had to do that. I don't even got nobody.
He said he keeps it 100 though. You know,
I ain't got nobody I got to answer to like that right now. Okay. Shit. I think the last lie I told.
What you lying about, Kapri?
Shit. Oh, today, the barber I got my hair cut by. I told his ass I'd be back. I'd never be back.
Nope.
You know, I paid the man, but I'd never go back. I mean, and it's not because he's a bad barber. Obviously, you see my shit is nice and tight.
Oh, on that part. Okay.
You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, the cut was 60, though. I'm not fucking, what's buddy name, YK Osiris? Mm-hmm. I do not find any privilege in paying or overpriced for a cut. I got my barber cut my hair for $25.
Looks good, man.
So what's you the normal what price?
Price, obviously, is like $45. You know what I'm saying?
Something like that.
But I only got a half a head, though. I only got a full head of hair.
That's true.
So it's just like, for you to charge me 60, that's not even 100 bones. Like, that's a full-blown everything from the best barber out.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You're getting like a lineup for real.
I'm just getting a lineup. I'm just like, okay, 60 bones, and there's nothing wrong with his price. It's about the fact that I just pay cheaper. I got a barber that's fire who charged me $25. I mean, I'm like, I was talking to my people about this earlier, 25 or 60. I mean, I don't got to be rich or broke to know which one I'm going to go with. Like, it's $25.
If it's the same haircut.
It's the same exact haircut, and that's why. You know, I told him I'd be back, but I probably won't. I'm going to go back to my $25 guy.
He lied to the barber, right. Y'all.
I lied to the barber. I'm sorry.
Next
but
up.
But you is dope, though, gang. You is dope, though. I don't even get it twisted.
Next up, would you rather be married to a 10 with a bad personality or a 5 with amazing personality?
Mm.
5 amazing personality. She got to have a big booty, though.
Oh, my God. Here we go.
Kevin Hart or Dave Chappelle?
Dave Chappelle, hands down. Oh, I don't even mean to throw no shade at my boy like that, but Dave Chappelle, bro, man, that's all laughter from my whole childhood. You know what I'm saying?
He tells different types of jokes. Kevin and Dave are like different.
Yeah, I definitely see where you're going with that because, you know, you got your Mike Epps funny.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Somebody who, like, they going to go into the joke and that's what's going to make it funny. Like, Kevin Hart is, like, facial expression funny to me.
Yeah.
Like, he's going to tell a joke and make a funny face. And
with
then,
the sound effects
exactly,
on top of it, yeah.
Boom.
What's worse, laundry or dishes?
Both.
Dishes. I hate dishes.
Would you rather have paper plates or the good plates?
Paper plates.
Okay, baby. Online shopping or in a store?
In the store.
Passenger or driver?
Driver.
At a movie, candy or popcorn?
Both.
Toilet paper.
I gotta have a fucking watermelon chews with the popcorn.
Oh, those are so good.
Toilet
yes.
paper, over or under?
Under.
All right, man. There it is.
There it is.
You know what I mean?
I gotta say over. Toilet paper over.
Well, wait, you said under?
Under.
Oh, no, it's gotta be over.
Over.
No, under, because it's just like, it's right there. You just pull it. Pull it and it just, you know what I'm saying?
Under is when you have kids, so I get it.
Yeah, I'm used to it over. I'm tall, so
I don't know if that correlates.
Yeah, because under, when you have kids, it's like if you have it over, kids are going to like, woof, like rip the whole paper.
Okay, I ain't think. Yeah. Real deal, but I just like to go under for that reason for myself. I just be grabbing.
It just seems awkward, like pulling it under.
I mean, like when I pull it under, I just grab like 3 or 4 pieces and I just.
Yo, if I see it, if I'm at somebody else's house, I don't
rip my toilet paper off real nice. I always try to do the little one swipe trick, you know? I'm saying, let me see if I can just pull in.
If I see it like that, like under, and I'm at somebody else's house, I'll switch it around.
Oh, you fix
you
it
ain't
for
shit.
Them?
For sure. For you sure. That's kind of fucked up.
Not you touching people's things without their permission.
Well, I'm using it. You know, I'm using it. And, you know, it's different.
How many pieces of toilet paper are you using?
Honestly, it depends on the number, you know.
You talking about if it's Charmin or if it's the Scotts.
Oh, no. Well, first off, if it's got to be at least 2-ply, you know what I mean? I went to somebody's house the other day and I used their restroom and I was just doing a number 2, you know, and they had a
not
really
thin. Not you shitting at people's houses.
Well, yeah, I knew that.
I was shit at people.
Yeah, for sure.
It is what it is.
You got to do it. And I'm going to judge
you if your toilet seat ain't clean, too.
Well, I got to take a shit.
You
really
lift it.
Oh, that's the worst. And I see somebody who can't clean a toilet. If I go to a girl house and you got a dirty toilet, I swear to God, you will never. That's to get me to ghost you. Come, let me come to your crib. You got a dirty toilet. I know you sitting your ass on a dirty toilet. You're not sitting down on me.
No, thank you.
Hell
no.
You know that booty, got full of germs. Ain't no squad. Yeah. Ain't no squad no this, baby.
She be like, yo, I'm gonna go to the bathroom and clean up. You know what's in there.
Exactly.
No.
Fucking little Osmosis Jones and them running around all on your fucking toilet and shit.
Oh, no. I didn't even think about that. Yo, no, yeah, before she sit on your face, you gotta go.
Okay, let's stop. Okay, we gonna stop it right there.
Whoa.
Man, anyway, we gotta shake, man. Thank you so much for coming by.
No problem, man.
I appreciate you, man.
And I appreciate y'all for having me.
Any last bit of information want anybody to know before you head back to Chi-Town about you, your music, your career, where you're headed, what to look out for?
Hey, man, I'm just going to tell you, keep your eyes peeled, and if you bet on anybody, you better bet on me.
Let's go!
You know what I'm saying? Seven nights coming out real soon, but just know I'm dropping these singles till then. We got All coming out second week of December, so be ready for that video, all that. We're going to keep the hits rolling.
Where they find you on social media?
Hey, y'all can follow me at 3KingBiz5. Once again, that's 3KingBiz5 on all social media platforms. So
King Biz, baby. It's King Business up in here.
Yes, sir.
Just Kapri, man. Thank you, guys.
Let's go.
Rockstar Radio Podcast. Nick Nack.
Kalisha.
We up out of here.
Hey.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
Rockstar Radio Podcast.